Hello and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm just gonna show you how I got this angelic look. So I will be showing you how I made the head mostly, and a little bit detail about the shirt, and also I have skirt for it. So I did actually this angelic look last year. I was watching the Ellie Max tutorial, kind of how to make the head, but at the end I was not really happy about it, so I will be doing it again, and hopefully this time it's gonna be better and I will change a little bit the style I did it. So first I'm just gonna take this modeling clay. It's gonna like air dry to be hard, so I'm just gonna flatten it and place it on my head, or my what I have made. And if you're gonna use some like you know, like those other heads, make sure it's like a little bit your head size, because last year that I made the head it was different sized. So I recommend placing some sort of back or like something under and between the head and the modeling clay, because for this head there is actually tons of glue on top of it, so it didn't that well like stick, but it's easier to remove if there's like back or something. After it's shaped of how you want, I tried to make it as flat as possible on the sides. I'm just taking this tool and carving these things on the head. After that, I'm just gonna let it air dry, and I will be cutting it a little bit smaller later. So now I'm just gonna do these flaps on the head. So I just place paper and draw a little pattern what kind of shape I need. So just tape this paper and I turn it around, and then I just draw it the shape I wanted this be. So the last years I did have quite like small these, and they were quite hard because I glued them or like on top. So this time I'm just gonna make them a little bit longer like on the picture. And also I forgot to do it here, but do the things like where the iron is hanging to make kind of like pieces like stretching. So I just make the head a little bit smaller, the modeling clay one, and then I just cut this thing out of the paper. What should we call these? Flaps. So I'll be cutting the pattern out, and then I'm gonna draw it on this baking sheet. I will be drawing the both sides on the paper, and I'm gonna turn the paper around because the liquid latex is gonna get the black moved to the latex, so we don't want any color to leave on it. And now I'm just gonna take normal toilet paper, and there's this pattern on the top side, so I will be taking the top out, and then just like part these, so there's like three layers, so I'm just gonna top layer off and then like part them, which seems to be really hard. So I'm just gonna take this liquid latex and tap it onto the baking sheet and applying this layer of the toilet papers. And when the bottom layer is done, I will be adding like another layer of toilet paper. I did let the toilet papers dry a little bit, and if you have some way that the baking sheet doesn't get like wrinkly, then it would be actually a little better. But I'm just taking these cotton things and rip them out, like making them thinner on the package. Like there's like three layers on them, I think, like on the toilet papers. So thin it out, and then I'm just gonna apply this cotton on top of the toilet papers. And I will be not adding than just this one layer, and I'm trying to make it as thin as possible, so it's gonna look like better, and also the head, when you place it, it's not gonna be bulky. So at least when you make it, try to make the insides quite thin, so it doesn't thicken the head. When they're done, I'm just gonna let them dry overnight and cut them out on them shape. Now moving to the modeling clay head, and it's dried, and I have cutten it a little bit the edges to fit better or to be the size I want. And I'm just gonna take this cotton and paint it with these oil paints. When the paint job is done, I'm gonna take this red thread and just take pieces so they're not these chunks, but they look a little bit like veins. And I'm just gonna apply this normal wood glue on top of the head and apply the threads. And basically I'm doing this kind of like Ellie Max Angelique, the head video she had. I'm gonna link it down below if you wanna see more like options how to do this. But last time I watched the videos, and the head turned out quite like thick, so this time I just tried to a little bit modify it and make it thinner, so it would be easier to place on the head later. When the threads are on them place, I'm just gonna add wood glue on top of them also, and just gonna let them dry. I'm now taking liquid latex and these cottons and placing them between kind of like my head and the skull head, and trying to lay as a thin layer as possible. And I will be doing the same thing with these flappy part things. So now I'm just gonna place this on top of the liquid latex cotton and on the head's line. And I'm just gonna use tape to keep it on its place. It's quite tricky, but if you first use the tapes and then I will be adding like the cotton latex again, so just let it dry if you feel like it's not gonna hold without the tapes, so don't put it on top of the tapes, just like put it between where's not the tape and let it dry and then remove the tapes and make the other parts, because you don't want the tape there. Try and make it as thin as possible, like the line, so it's gonna be easier to apply on the head, but still that line between these and these flaps and the head wouldn't be like showing, but still it's like thinned out at the end, so the application will be better. After this, I just remove the head on the head and cut it out the latex thing for like a little bit smaller. And for these flaps, I'm this time taking liquid latex and the threads and placing them on top of the flappy pieces. And also I will be adding this liquid latex on top of the thread, so there's like nothing flying, you know, the fur on the thread, you know. Now I'm just gonna put it back on the head and start painting this. So last time I used the cream colors on just normal cream paints on your like body face, but this time I have these alcohol activated paints and I will be using these. So first I'm just gonna like pack it a little bit with this sponge on like everywhere, and then going on with the all of these like red colors and using it a little bit on to the like the modeling clay head there and then on top of the flappy parts. And when I'm happy with it, the painting, the head is basically done. I will be coating it with this matte no tack paint. It's like flexible paint, so the flappy parts don't get like stiff like on the other one. I used glue, so this is like flexible and I've been using it on all over my like latex mask what I have done, and it's really good, really good. So here is the shirt I made.
last year for my Angelique. I didn't have any videos, I didn't film last year. I did it quite in a hurry, this one. I did also some parts at work, like hand to these parts there, so, but I can insert some pictures on the screen so you can get some sort of idea of that. So for this shirt on Angelique, I just took my normal shirt, cut it out and sew it, then I made this corset part with leather, with normal like corset pattern, and then added these liquid latex parts on it and glued and sewed them onto the shirt. Last year I had a little bit some problems with it. I didn't have any alcohol activated paints, so here as you can see, these were the old ones, and I did paint these today just a little bit lighter because my skin is quite like I'm pale and I have some like blood veins blue showing in my skin, and so I tried to make it more of my skin color, and these were the old ones, quite poor painting. I basically made it with foundation that would cover the yellow latex. I did use the L'Oreal True Mats. I think it was the second lightest shade, but the lightest is even too dark for me. So these are a little bit like wrong colored. Here I tried a little bit the red before, before, but it was like this, like the paint is leaving. Made with grease paints, these, and some of them are oil paints. And this is like crappy and gray. I made this corset part here. It's like separate, except it connects with the through the zipper on the back. And there's buttons for the neck. These not very greatly done since I did run out later, so I just cut it some pieces there. I glued these all parts on, and I actually these shoulder pieces I did sew on with hand. And after those I cover it the hand sewing with latex, so you cannot see this. And for these pieces, if you wanna get right sized for you or where you want them, I recommend using these kind of like plastic, what you get when you buy eyeshadow palettes. So I just put them on my like stomach. I draw the shape I want and just you put latex on top and then cut the shape. So you get exactly right what you wanted. Because I want this first to be like one colored, I am going over with these deeper alcohol activated paints, those three shades, last shades on the first row, and I'm just gonna tap it on, and that's the only way to cover all the like darker colors there too. So just gonna try to get it one colored first before going with the lighter shades. And after the first layer, I am just gonna start adding the lightest and the second lightest color and just tapping it on to the shoulders, and also doing the same thing on this small piece. After that, I am taking this other
skin illustration palette, and there's the white, and I'm just gonna go over everything with the white color. It's quite like transparent, so it's gonna be good for my skin to match it. And then I'm taking a little bit this blue shade and just drawing it on there, because in my skin there's like blood veins and things showing, so a little bit blue to match more my skin color. And on top of it, taking the lightest shade there and just kind of like tapping it on like these dots there. Again, a little bit over the blue ones also for the spikes, and quite like these wrinkle things, I'm adding these again, these deeper colors a little bit, and just like shading them and also shading the spikes so it's not gonna be my skin color and then just suddenly red. And yeah, lastly going with the red colors on the spikes and adding a little bit red onto these like wrinkles and these smaller pieces also.
Nice. I was explaining everything what I do to this Angelique's head, like these things. And I didn't even film. Why nobody told me? Okay, so we have like one string left, so let's just show that one. At least we have something left. So what we gonna need is this metal wire, a little bit thicker one. You can basically find it at where's all the like crafty stuff. At least in Finland, like a supermarket. So I will be bending this like here, and then we are gonna bend this edge, another edge. This is basically same size as my elastic wire, this silver, which is nice that they look same, but we're gonna bend it and it's gonna look like this. I will cut a little bit the tail out. So it looks like this. And then we're gonna put it through on our Angelique's head and then squeeze it together. That it closes like this. After that we are gonna take thread and needle and a little bit trying to tie this around it. After that, I'm gonna take the elastic band and put it here in the middle and just gonna go through it.
gonna go through it like a couple times.
Like that. And lastly, just gonna like a little bit roll this thread around it.
It will hold there like quite fine, and but I wouldn't recommend pulling it hard. Then I'm gonna cut a piece of this crafty foam. Something like this piece. I'm gonna use super glue and glue it a little bit the edges, and then this is the front side, so we're gonna place the good size side here and then turn these onto the back side. And squeeze it. And it will look like this. So it does hold quite goodly after this, the like super glue also. We can paint these to silver with the desiring paint we like. So eyebrow, just gonna use some glue, and I don't even have mirror. I'm just gonna put the glue and then press it on my fingers to my skin. So I'm not actually sure am I gonna cover them more, but at least they are now in their places. I'm gonna add this NYX eyeshadow base. It's white one. So I was thinking maybe I should start a little bit with the brown. Maybe this shade here and this one. And then I'm just gonna go over with this eyelid with the black pen. I was a little bit talking still on the video, but I'm just gonna take over here on my desk. So I'm just gonna blend it with the small brush, the black jumbo pen what we placed, and then taking this NYX Epic Ink Liner and just lining around my eye. And on top of the black pen, I am just gonna take this Jeffree Star's Cremated palette and put this black on top of the black pen. Then when I'm happy with the eyes, I'm moving on putting the head, and I first laid the bald cap, but I'm not gonna glue it onto my head, and then going over with this angelic head, and I made this kind of like bald cap attached to the head, so it would be more like smoother looking, like it would be easier to apply. So I'm just attaching this on my head with prosthetic adhesive, and I made a big mistake for applying this under my eyebrows and on kind of like the nose. It just not work, and don't do it. I was gonna rip it off and do it again, but I didn't have time for it. For the head latex part, I have this old L'Oreal True Match foundation. It's the lightest shade, but it's quite not matched to my skin, but it's perfect for covering like the latex and so like pigmented. For the face, I'm using the NYX Bare With Me Skin Veil and mixing two colors there, and then using this Cool Ivory Maybelline Multi-Use Concealer and just using it on like under eyes and on the nose and a little bit on the red areas that I get. For contouring, I'm using this Morphe's contour stick and just trying to watch the angelic picture, reference picture, and just adding it and trying to make my head shape as her. And so I'm just gonna use this stick normally as I would on my face, and on top of the bald cap liquid latex piece I am a little bit like packing it on, because it doesn't that well stick, so I'm just not gonna use the just only the stick and blend it with beauty blender. I'm tapping it on and then blending it, and then the shade will be quite like same all the time. On top of the contour, I'm using the Morphe and Coca-Cola palette just to add a little bit more color than just this one color. And yeah, the nose and the under the eyebrows, the bald cap or this piece looks really bad. So I should have put it on top of my eyebrows and not at all in my nose, because that shit just don't work. But yeah, I am taking this PH Cosmetics blush palette. It is the nude blush palette with 10 different shades, and it was the first one in first row. And also on these eyes and nose, or kind of like the eyebrow area, I will be tapping on the Morphe's contour stick and then just a little bit blending it out and using on top these Morphe's eyeshadows. I'm also a little bit adding like red on there and connecting it on my eyeshadow. And the black eyeshadow, I just need to keep adding it on top, because the eyeshadow just falls out on the black one. For the beauty marks, I'm using the Epic Ink Liner, doing first these small dots, and because they are not black probably ever. I'm a little bit dabbing on this brown eyeshadow on top, so they would look a little bit more natural. On top of the eyebrow, or not existing eyebrow area, I am just tapping on this concealer, the Cool Ivory, just to lighten it a little bit, and so my messy work wouldn't show that much, that there's like contrast in those and not wrinkles. Then a little bit contouring more my forehead. I felt like it's not good enough. For the last thing, I am aligning my lips with the black, just normal eyeliner, and adding on this Jeffree Star's liquid lipstick. I think this is the Wifey. It's on the red, like where's the 8 mini liquid lipsticks. Some of them are dried, but I have a couple left, so I think this is the Wifey one. And then going on top again with the black eyeliner and a little bit blending the sides and putting on top NYX Candy Slick, this kind of like lip gloss. And after the lips, my look is complete. If you made this far in my million hour video, thank you for watching, and I hope you find this helpful if you are gonna do Angelique. And I'm sorry for not showing how I made my full costume, but there's gonna be small video clip at the end how it looked. And I'm actually sad that I didn't take any pictures, than just only small video clip on it. And if I want it, I need to do this again, so I will probably never do this again. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video and find it helpful, and please give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you feel like it, and see you on my next video. Oh, and at the end I need to put my bye.